Welcome everyone to Tucson, Arizona in the second round of the NCAA tournament. It's the 12th seeded Aggies of Utah State and the 5th seeded Wildcats of Kansas State. Hi everyone, alongside Dan Bonner and Reggie Miller, Sam Ryan on our sideline, Kevin Harlan, thank you for joining us. One of the best guards in college basketball resides with the Wildcats and Jacob Pullen.
Kevin, he's not only one of the best guards in college basketball, he's one of the best players in college basketball. And understand now, this is more than a guard with a famous beard. This is a guy who can really play. He's a great three-point shooter, but that's not the extent of his game. He can get to the line. He can drive the ball to the basket. He's extremely aggressive, a high-energy player who missed yesterday's workouts with a fever, but I talked to him a little while ago. He said he wasn't 100%, but he was going to go, and he was going to be fine.
The WAC Player of the Year plays for Utah State.
Well, Pullen will certainly be the best perimeter player on the floor, but the best low post player will be Ty Wesley. Almost 15 points on the season this year, 59% from the field, can go either way, shoot over either shoulder. But what I like, he's a man of my heart. He's a great agitator. I feel he's going to get underneath the skin of some of these Wildcat players.
The Utah State Aggies from Logan, Utah. The Kansas State Wildcats from Manhattan, Kansas. Our tip-off moments away on True TV.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, Burger King, and by Nationwide Insurance.
Moments ago, K-State coach Frank Martin addressed his Wildcats.
Don't let a bad play, bad shot, bad call, a turnover, don't let that break your spirit. Don't let that break your spirit. The work to win has been done. Now we'll go out there and do it. Let's go.
As we take a look at our starting lineups.
Number three for me for the Utah State Aggies, Brockeith Payne, the junior. He's a penetrator. He can get you the basket. Also lead these Aggies in assists as well as steals.
And number 22 for Kansas State, guard Rodney Magruder. He's really the X factor. He has as many three-point baskets made as Jacob Pullen. He's got to score effectively.
The fourth of our four games tonight from Tucson, brought to you in HD TV by LG. Life's good. Good group of officials tonight. John Cal has officiated 9 Final Fours. Mike Egger is in his 15th NCAA tournament. And Scott Twardowski is in his first NCAA tournament. You take a look at Utah State, Ty Wesley averaging 15 points and 8 rebounds a game. The Aggies have won 3 consecutive WAC regular season titles, and Wesley a big reason why.
Well, what I like about Wesley, again, that low post presence. At times, if you don't double team him, this is a guy that can score with either hand. He rebounds the ball. He blocks shots. And sets great screens for his teammates.
And they open in a man-to-man, and let's keep an eye on Jacob Pullen for Kansas State and see if he really is as healthy as he says.
Samuels and Wesley. And 2 quick ones inside the lane.
And nice. Kevin, it appears obvious that they're going to try to go after Ty Wesley. That's just throw the ball in the low post and let Samuels operate.
Brockeith Payne. And he'll be defended on the play by Jacob Pullen. Switch on defense.
I'm curious to see the energy level for Pullen. When you're sick and you're battling. Goaltend there by Southwell. You know, times when I played when I was sick, you never wanted to go outside your comfort level. You tried to play within yourself to conserve energy. Let's see if Pullen has that energy here for the Wildcats.
Junior Bendel makes the 2 points right there on the goaltend, which ties our game at 2.
Utah State looked pretty good on that possession. Stu Morrill told us yesterday his big questions were, can his Aggies relax and run their offense under pressure? can they relax and handle the big stage, and can they rebound the ball?
Samuels again.
And there you saw the Aggies drop into that matchup zone there. Samuels right in the middle there, wide open shot, just couldn't convert.
Payne, Wesley. Nice block inside, Curtis Kelly, and pulling the other way. Chiseling his way, that's a nice knock away by Wesley.
Oh, he's gonna block some shots.
Pulling for three.
Already, Wesley and Kelly getting into it down low.
Newbold. Nice rebound inside, or at least it looked that way by Shane Southwell. Utah State will get it. We think. Let's see. Yep. With about 2 minutes gone here in the first half.
Newbold's a pretty good three-point shooter, Reggie, but do you think that Utah State wants to play that quick a pace?
No, they don't. It's a controlled tempo. They want to control the pace. They want to take a lot of quick shots.
Stu Morrill, the coach at Utah State, was concerned his team may be overpowered physically by this team from the BCS.
He said that's always a concern when you're playing one of the teams from one of the power conferences. And they were overpowered, he thought, last year in the first round by Texas A&M. They throw it away right there.
Well, already you see the pressure by this Kansas State team. They're really going to get after you defensively. They're going to overplay. They're going to deny the wings. Going to do a better job of executing your offense.
And that's what Stu Morrill told us yesterday. You know, he was really had some questions about whether or not they could run their offense against the pressure he knew he was going to see.
Long shot there by Curtis Kelly won't go. And the rebound was hauled in by Nieder. He takes it the other way, faces Magruder. He's looking for Wessler. A turnover right there by the Aggies.
Back-to-back turnovers for the Aggies.
Southwell gets that to roll in. He is a freshman from Harlem, New York. Became a starter back in mid-January.
And he does not do a great deal offensively, but he's a pretty good defender. He rebounds the ball. And if you let him get out and run in transition, he can finish.
Drive inside by Payne. Here comes Pullen. Little pump fake, and he drives into the defense of Pooh Williams, who picks up the foul for the Aggies, and that's the first on him.
And again, they're out and running, and this is what Kansas State wants to do, and Utah State, they just did not get back quickly enough. Brock Keith Payne, I mean, he's on an island right there, not really very much he can do.
Pulling off a screen. And they'll reload. Last time we saw K-State, they were losing to Colorado in the Big 12 tournament by 12 in Kansas City. Kelly setting a screen pull. Throws that away as he's looking for Samuels on the other side.
Or was he looking for Manute Bol?
Maybe, yeah.
One of the two. I know both teams are a little tentative offensively.
Seems that way, doesn't it, Reggie? Yeah,
turnovers on both sides.
Now, both are very good defensive teams.
Williams. Newbold. Screen right there that opens them up, and they go outside to Williams.
36% three-point shooter. They're going to need some of those to go down.
Wildcats have started 2-6.
And this zone, Reggie, has made K-State stop. We'll just stand them on offense.
But when you play zone, what's usually open? That middle section right there. You just got to be able to pass the ball to one another. You're in the zone. You got to look in the middle, either in a pick and roll situation or look for your bigs in the middle. And it's very important for your bigs to be excellent passers in that zone.
Kelly gets the assist. Southwell puts it in. Southwell's got four. Williams. Southwell defends. Nice move by Williams to get inside. Keith Payne. Wesley. That's out of bounds. That's a turnover. There's Wesley. That's the WAC player of the year we're talking about. Throws it away. With the Kelly assist, Southwell finds the deuce in the Wildcats by one.
Ernie Johnson in New York, HP tournament update. Unlike Utah State, which is senior dominated, Gonzaga only has one senior. This is the man, Stephen Gray. And on CBS, part of a 12-0 run as they're out to the early lead over St. John's. Back to you, Kevin.
EJ, thank you very much. EJ's right. This is an upperclassman lineup for Utah State.
And it's an upperclassman lineup that's thrown the ball out the door three times so far, and they cannot afford turnovers if they're going to be able to win this particular ball game.
Will Spradling has come in. Henriquez Roberts is coming now for the Wildcats.
And it's really been a sloppy game, really, on both sides.
McCruder inside. And crushed onto in there by the senior Nate Bendel. He's out of Salt Lake City. Set the screen. 15 and a half to play here in the first half with a foul away from the ball.
Payne is going to have to do something on the offensive end of trying to get, we talked about it at the open, penetrate, get into the paint, because then he can suffocate that K-State defense and try to dish it out for some of these shooters on Utah State.
Reggie, I agree with you. Utah State offense works much better when Brakeith Payne is getting the ball into the lane.
Ryan Green, Brady Jardine eject in for the Aggies.
Now, if you're Kansas State, you better find Green because he's an outstanding three-point shooter, and they've got Jacob pulling on him.
Well, 47%, you're right.
Third leading scorer on this Aggie team coming off the bench.
Drew Williams, McGruder's up. Rakeith Payne, the freshman scrambling on him. And the shot clock down to 10. Payne for three. And Enriquez Roberts is going after the ball. It's off of Utah State. And the Wildcats will get it back. Four of their 6 points have come inside the lane. And here comes Jacob Pullet.
Well, Ty Wesley going to the bench for the Aggies. And Poole Williams offensively has to be a little bit more aggressive offensively, along with Green.
You know, I think Bendel's doing a pretty nice job getting position inside, but they haven't been looking in there. The K-State pressure on the basketball has prevented the guards from seeing Bendel open inside.
Henriquez Roberts, McGruder, shot clock down to 7. Pullen, doubled, drives, can't get it to go. All the way down to 3 on the shot clock and a foul called against the Aggies.
Bowen did a wonderful job there of really not settling for that three when the ball was swung to him. I hear he pump fakes, and you think he's going to take a mid-range shot and decides to go all the way into the paint.
Bendel picks up the foul. Sam, what about this terrific senior out of Maywood, Illinois, Jacob Pullen?
Well, you talked earlier about him visiting Eastern's practice with a fever. They even had to IV him. He was rooming with Devon Peterson at the time, but K-State coaches decided to put Jacob in his own room just as a precaution. He's out there tonight, guys.
Again, I want to see what his energy level is. Remember, Jacob Pullen was one of the, listening to head coach Frank Martin, talked about his best perimeter defender. This is a guy that picks up full court pressure defense.
First ever K-State Wildcat named preseason All-America by the AP. He'll take a breather right now. Maybe even said he's having a hard time breathing.
Did you see that? Yeah, sure did. He looks tired.
Yep. Absolutely. He said he was having a tough time breathing, Kevin. Good catch.
Octavius Irving is in. It is scooped to Jardine with a nice feed by Drew Williams on the drive for the Aggies.
Now, Jardine is a tremendously athletic young man, and that athleticism may be extremely important as they play against this Kansas State squad tonight.
So a freshman at the point, a sophomore Irving at the two, and here we go. 7 minutes gone here in the first half. Henriquez Roberts. Jamar Samuels, and a nice looking shot in the circle, hit by Rodney McGruder. He's got his first two.
It's that area in the zone, Reggie, you're talking about. They've been able to find it for passes, and now if you're going to let McGruder catch the ball there, he might have 50.
Aggies have started 3 of 7. This is Green. You talked about him lacing up the three, and he puts one over Irving from downtown.
Little token pressure here. All they're trying to do is make K-State run some time off the clock, and they drop back into that zone.
And another person that's going to be key in this zone is the guy with the ball, Will Spradling. We talked about Brian Green being able to be a zone buster. So is Spradling.
McGruder for three. Good! baseline. He puts it in. He had Wesley right in his face.
You know, we talked about him from in the middle. Yeah. He's pretty good from out there.
He's not bad. He's not bad. He averages about 11 points a game for Frank Martin's Wildcats.
And that was three-point basket number 68 on the year, so he is a threat from out there.
Wesley steamrolls his way inside the paint. And guys were grabbing and trying to get him. And a Wildcat foul. Magruder from outside. He's been coming on strong. He buries one from three, and the Cats on top by three.
This March, get the inside scoop on all the madness straight from some of the top names in sports on SI.com's Behind the Mic. Behind the Mic gives you direct access to the experts.
Free app now.
Magruder has started 2-3. Jacob Pullen on the bench, battling the flu. He is 0-2. Let's take a look at the Infinity Coaches Spotlight. And there is Stu Merrill, who has had a terrific 13-year stand at Utah State.
Well, he was so much fun when we talked to him yesterday. You know, he was talking about the fact that when his team comes in, they were hoping for a seed that would be a little bit better, but he said no matter what seed they got, they're going to have to come in here and play a really, really good team.
Wesley at the line. Stu Morrill was a junior college All-America, a two-time All-Big Sky player at Gonzaga, played a year of pro basketball in France, has found a home in Logan. Wesley at the line. Samuels cleans it up, pulling back in the game.
And two big misses for Ty Wesley.
Yeah, you got to convert those. Now they're back to the man-to-man.
Kelly, backdoor, Spradling, snaps it out, Magruder for three. Wesley the rebound. They push the pitch. Here comes Brock Keith Payne. Wesley a screen. Spradling fights through it, defends, and draws the foul.
And that's what I want to see from Payne. Put pressure, especially in transition. You've got to put pressure on that Kansas State defense, because if not, these guys are too good. They move their feet, especially with Spradling guarding him. Try to get to the basket.
This Utah State team, the best shooting team in the WAC, and tonight they have started 4 of 8. Rockeith Payne at the line is a junior from Dallas, Texas. He goes. Missing right there. Watch every tournament game live online with NCAA March Madness on Demand at mmod.ncaa.com.
Three straight free throw misses for the Utah State Aggies.
And Payne, an 80% free throw shooter coming in. Wesley, who missed the previous two, a 72% free throw shooter.
Jacob Pullen, two-time first-team All-Big 12 selection. Payne is in front of him. Samuels, picked up by Jardine. Kelly, working on Wesley. Nice spin, takes it to the rack. Pretty play.
And that's a nice, quick move for a big. One dribble, drop step, curl move, and then use the glass.
And Reggie, they had everybody above the free throw line with their offensive setup, and so it's almost like a clear out for Kelly. That's going to be hard for Wesley to defend one-on-one.
Now here's Wesley. Right at Kelly. Leans in and finds out two. Nice play by Ty Wesley.
Two different ways, the way Kelly scored and now the way Ty Wesley. Wesley goes straight through the body of Kelly. Not trying to go around, just goes right through the chest. And look at Kelly. Kelly uses that quickness and spin move to go away from Wesley.
This is a problem for Kelly now, because Wesley is good, patient moves in the low post, misses another free throw. But Kelly's got to be careful. He doesn't want to pick up another foul here and have to go to the bench.
Kelly picked up his first foul. Tyler Newbold is checked in for Utah State. Inside, pretty pass. They can't convert with Samuels, and here come the Aggies the other way.
Well, that's what Stu Morrill was talking about to us, that they were going to double-team Kelly, try to get the ball out of his hand.
Rockeith Payne, Spradling on his own.
They did, and they dodged a bullet there, Reggie, because Samuels missed one from point-blank range.
Wesley fumbles it away. Little game of twister. Little tie-up. You see some scores, some other games. Gonzaga taking on St. John's. Michigan State and UCLA. So far, the Bruins are romping over the Spartans. Missouri and Cincinnati. And BYU Jimmer Fredette had a win tonight. Wisconsin won here earlier in games three of our four over Belmont. A lot of people had that game circled. Think of it. Badgers may struggle, but they win it. West Virginia took care of Clemson earlier today. And a long shot by Green will not go in. They kind of think Brian Green, and you mentioned this before, Danny, a good three-point shooter. He is the X factor for this team. When he gets out, hits that three-point shot. Watch out.
That's what you have to do to him. You can't let him just stand there and catch the ball and shoot it. You got to make him dribble the ball, do something with it. And they disrupted his three-point shooting rhythm and got him a miss.
Newbold picked up his first. Pollen just got the pass. And a quick whistle. And a foul goes on Ty Wesley. He picks up his first personal for Utah State.
Well, this is really interesting. Both of those inside guys, Wesley for Utah State, Kelly for Kansas State, are so valuable to their respective teams. They have to somehow stay in the game.
Absolutely. There's no way Wesley can get in foul trouble because he's really their only low post threat for the Aggies.
Southwell back in. Pulling. Kelly with the screen. Way outside, Jamal Samuels. And controlled nicely by Tyler Newbold. Wesley.
That's ridiculous. Dan, I'm sorry. That is ridiculous.
Reggie, in the college game, that's the way that one's called. Anytime you lower that shoulder and put it into somebody's chest, you're going to get called for a foul.
Did he lower the shoulder? He dribbled one time.
That is a flop. And you're talking to a guy who was the master of it.
Well, see, now you would probably recognize it better than most people.
That's right. I appreciate it, but that's a bad call.
Kelly, Southwell, Spradling, Pullen.
And now Wesley's probably done for the rest of this half with those two fouls.
Yeah, I would say so.
Kelly inside, button was Pullen! What a pass by Kelly with another good-looking assist. Pullen slides in for the deuce.
Jacob Pullen, he doesn't seem to be moving around quite as well. The fact is illness seems to be bothering, but he's such a tough guy. He doesn't need to make jump shots. He can get himself in the lane, score tough baskets, and go to the free throw line.
Jardine picked up the foul. Here is Pullen at the line, a 77% free throw shooter.
Well, offensively now, if you're Stu Morrell, where do you get the offense coming from? Brian Green off the bench has already knocked down one, but maybe Tyler Newbold, Jardine.
I think Newbold has to be able to score, and I think you've got to be able to throw it inside to Nate Bendel.
K-State foul, James Walker in the game, the freshman from Long Beach, California for Utah State.
And that's two fouls on Curtis Kelly, and that'll drive a coach crazy when your big guy, somebody upon whom you rely to score on the inside, picks up a foul.
Samuels actually
Samuels,
got
this, yeah. Okay.
Well, Samuels got his second.
Well, that's Samuels' second. You don't want your big guys fouling somebody half court. The principle applies. I had the wrong big guy.
Walker, Newbold, Green. He'll put up another three. Jardine aggressively goes. Spradling holding on. K-State comes out with it. Here comes Pullen on the fly. Dancing and snapping it outside. Southwell for three. Kelly cleans it up. Frenetic pace. Walker flies in. Offensive foul.
You could see that one coming from half court. Don't you have to give that ball up, Reggie?
You do.
Get
on,
it
a
back?
On a two-on-one situation, you got to be able to score the basketball here, right? Give the basketball up, and that's a nice move on Will Spradley to come up with a charge. But two-on-one, kick the ball ahead. You'll get it back.
First foul on James Walker. K-State has the biggest lead tonight of five. Couple ties, couple lead changes.
Danger zone here, I think, for Utah State. Wesley's on the bench. They've turned it over a couple times. They've got to count on their defense here until their offense can get going.
Jardine knocked it away, 19 on the shot clock.
If you're Utah State and Stu Morrell, you just want to get out of this half within striking distance with your best player on the bench with two fouls and Ty Wesley.
Utah State went field goal in the last 4.5 minutes.
Well, where's their offense going to come from? Wesley is on the bench. Williams really hasn't done anything.
Offensive rebound, Henry Gills Roberts on the miss by Spradlin. Pullen taking a look back at his coach, Frank Walker. One of the most animated coaches in all of college basketball. Pullen for three. And the rebound by Brady Jardine. Walker, freshman against freshman. Spradlin defends. Bendel had it. Out of bounds it goes. K-State by five, 7:37 to play in the first half from Tucson.
St. John's to Gonzaga. You got a Big East team winning Cincinnati over Missouri on CBS and on TNT. Of course, you can switch around. That's the way it works these days, but you might miss a great call by Kevin Harlan. Totally up to you, Kevin.
Thanks. Now, when are we going to get this great call?
Hold on to your hats.
Checks in the mail, Ernie.
We've seen Louisville lose. They're a Big East team. They lost earlier in the day in a surprise. A four-seed Cardinal team. Magruder, Kelly drawing a quick double. That means Henriquez Roberts is inside, and he had some room, and then he was quickly hacked at by Brock Heath Payne, who picks up his first personal foul. You know, it's interesting because Utah on the turnovers has turned it over 6-1 compared with K-State. That results in seven more attempts by the Wildcats.
And that was also, Reggie, you've talked about the passing ability of the Kansas State big guys. Yes. And what you saw right there by Curtis Kelly, he could see the double team coming as Henriquez Roberts knocks down the first one. The most important thing you have to do when you're double team is turn toward the basket.
Right.
So you can see who's available. And he made that turn despite the double team and found his and Henriquez Roberts.
Right now, Utah State is in a very scary position, because they don't have a lot of scoring on the floor right here, and I believe the pressure of Kansas State is really disrupting their offense. You don't want this game to get away from you in this first half.
And the big gun, Wesley, the last player of the year, is on the bench with two fouls. Payne dribbling around traffic. The athleticism of K-State. There's a steal by Kelly. He gets it out to Magruder, and Pullen will orchestrate with a Kelly screen. Jacob Pullen. Curtis Kelly. Henriquez Roberts can't find it. Somehow Magruder gets the loose ball. Until reset.
Henriquez Roberts is one long Wildcat.
He is long. Nice pass inside. Southwell. And he finds Pullen. He's got seven for the Wildcats.
Reggie, and you can see how dangerous the folks from Utah State think this is. Ty Wesley with his two fouls is over there ready to come back in the game because they can feel this game getting away. Now that is a flop. Give that guy a yellow card.
Oh, so you know the difference, huh?
Pendulous screen, Brock Heath Payne. Switch on defense. It's over the seven-footer, Henriquez Roberts. Bendel, the rebound, and the two.
Bendel for two.
Don't think you need to settle for that shot if you're Utah State. Run your offense, throw the ball inside.
Henriquez Roberts. Vacuumed in by Southwell.
New Kansas State runs some time off this clock.
Pulling with the dance. Into Henriquez Roberts in the pick and roll. Nicely executed. And Pullen leads to the fourth point of Henriquez Roberts. Pullen has got two assists. And Kansas State, razor sharp to begin this second round game in Tucson.
Miller Lite. The Hartford. And by Homefront.
Lot of stuff to buy here in Tucson as we take a look at the game summary so far. Reg, what stands out to you with those numbers?
Well, defensively, late rotations for the Utah State Aggies, which has really forced Coach Morrell to bring back his best player, Ty Wesley, with two fouls.
Only 14 field goal attempts for Utah State. They have not been able to handle the pressure, and that was one of the questions they had before the game.
Bendel With a Curtis Kelly rebound, Spradlin is back in.
And the pressure by Kansas State is forcing the Aggies into quick shots.
And that, as you said, Reg, that's not their offense.
Wesley is in. Molly was out. Utah State outscored by 7. The floater right here by Pullen, but he traveled. Wipe it away.
Now, the one thing about Jacob Pullen, you remember what Frank Martin said in the locker room? We heard him. Don't let a turnover bother you. Jacob Pullen weren't. He'll just keep playing. Probably bothers Frank Martin more than it does Jacob Pullen.
Well, most coaches it does.
Newbold, Payne, Blue Williams. Good offensive rebound right there by Bender.
Well, it was good offense overall. They moved the ball side to side. They got an open three. They weren't able to convert. But because they moved the defense around, they were able to get the offensive rebound.
Utah State, 6 of 15, 40%. Williams, Newbold, screen right there by Wesley. Rocky Payne. Another Wesley screen. Ty's got it. Doubled.
Kelly's got to be careful.
I knew it.
Wow. Oh.
Too aggressive.
That is number 3 on Ty Wesley.
And that was a frustration foul right there. He felt that he was fouled on his shot opportunity, and he was talking to himself on the bench and understood that he's put his team in a very, very tough situation right here. He thought he was fouled right there on the second shot opportunity. Just comes over the top of Kelly right there, picking up his third foul of this first half.
You know, he's fouled out of 4 games. Sam, what do you have?
Official mascot for the Aggies, 27-year-old, 300-pound senior Bill Sproat, also known to fans as Wild Bill. He sits behind the hoop, tries to distract the opposing team when at the free throw line by losing his shirt sometimes. He's trying not to get in trouble, though, tonight. It's not a home game for them. He dresses in the Wild costumes today under his shirt. He's dressed as Dorothy from The Wizard of Oz, Kansas. Get it?
We're all trying not to lose our shirt. Devon Peterson has checked in for the Wildcats. Kansas State from the line, 7-7.
You know, this is the NCAA tournament, and they tend to be rather staid about those things, so he better keep that shirt on.
Jardine through Williams into a thicket of players, and he gets it to go from close range.
Well, finally, you know, finally something aggressive going to the basket. Williams doing a good job there, going to a strong hand, which is his left hand, and finishing.
Henriquez Roberts. And pulled in by Rocky Thane. Again, back on defense, Kansas State, Pooh Williams.
You need those. You're going to shoot quickly in transition. You've got to make baskets.
3.5 to play in the half. K-State is led by as many as 11. Devon Peterson trying to sneak it inside. That is a tie-up. Nate Bendel came over with some defense. And a timeout. 3:19 in the first half. The Wildcats on top of the Aggies. Kansas State on top. Both teams not shooting all that well. And coming up on the AT&T at the half, scores and highlights and the latest tournament news for the Naismith Watch, presented by AT&T. All coming up on the AT&T at the half. Kansas State leading 26-17. Kansas State began conference play in the Big 12 2-5. Then they won 8 of their next 9. They were a preseason number 3, fell out of the top 25, regrouped. Here they are as a number 5 seed. Pullen for 3. Good! Hits the deck, laces a triple. He's got 10 for the Wildcats.
Well, we talked about Jacob Pullen arguably being the best perimeter player, and he's showing it here in this game. That's just a dribble handoff. Pullen with a nice stretch 3.
Almost made the steal. He did. He knocked it against the dribbling Pooh Williams.
Guess it's going okay, huh?
It looks okay to me.
8 turnovers.
Now, this Kansas State defense is so intense and so aggressive, it really does have the Aggies back on their heels. And they're in trouble. They've got to get a couple of stops here. They cannot allow Kansas State to put this game away with a run here before the end of the first half.
Pulling. There's a little pass inside to the backpedaling Southwell, who fought. There's some traffic. Green was there. Bendel was there. And Bendel will pick up the foul.
Kansas State going to the free throw line for their eighth and ninth free throw of this first half. 7 of 7. See, all these little touchy fouls to the free throw lines, they add up.
And did you say that was Bendel's second foul?
It is.
So both of the starting big guys.
Uh-oh, my heavens.
Really?
Somewhere there is a mother shaking her head saying, what did I do wrong? He's borrowed my dress, and all of America is watching. That is not the Dorothy I remember from The Wizard of Oz. He fanned. Scrambling defender. 2.5 to play in the half. Pooh Williams, Jardine, good pass. Pooh Williams inside, they find two.
I'll tell you what, if I'm Utah State, if I can get out of this half with a little over 2 minutes left, I might have been traveling. Double
sure
drills,
is, yeah. You're right. So now there's a chance to grab 10. Momentum.
I want to get this to 10 or below because I have my two post players in trouble, in Newbold and Ty Wesley. If I can get these guys in the second half down only 10 or less, that's a moral victory for the Utah State Aggies.
Well, it gives you the idea that you can make a rally in the second half. So yeah, these last 2 minutes are extremely important.
Morgan Grimm has checked in for the first time for the Aggies. Rakeith Payne, Jardine, Pooh Williams, Grimm, and Green out there for Utah State in their third consecutive NCAA tournament.
Just everything is tough on the offensive end for Utah State.
Pooh Williams, that is a big-time three. And now you couple that with the 2 little 5-0 run here for the Aggies.
Now you've cut the lead down to 9.
Now keep coming. Dig in on defense.
Yes.
Get a stop. Keep coming.
A lot of times great defense is fueled by some offense.
And you got to be careful here with Jacob Pullen right here. This is the guy that can put a lot of pressure on your defense.
He's got a game high 10, does Pullen. Playing with the fever less than 100%.
And we're back in that zone.
Shot clock at 8. Kelly. The dance, the dive. And it's picked up by Green, and here come the Aggies.
That's great defense by Jardine inside. Now, you don't have to be in a hurry here.
Attack, Payne. Attack, attack, attack.
He attacks the freshman, Spradlin. And a rebound, and a good one it is by Rodney Magruder. He gets his second.
There's numbers.
Pulling. Southwell.
Oh, I love it. I love it. Wow. Get on the floor.
They are hustling. But that's the trademark of this Utah State team. Very aggressive, very experienced.
Scramble here by both teams here, and Payne just Green sacrificing his body, jumping over his own player.
Screws tightening here before halftime in Tucson. Wildcats still on top. All right, guys, let's step back and get some perspective here with the Wildcats on top, as they have been most of the first half. Right now, 31-22, Reg.
Well, really, the pressure defensively for Kansas State has really fueled their offense. And we didn't know what to expect from Jacob Pullen, and he's been fantastic in this first half.
Pullen. Shot clock is down to 10, and this is a long three. Spradlin with the rebound, a big one.
Right for the last shot, and I just looked at Stu Morrell's expression right there, and he's like, are you kidding me, guys?
Yeah, lots of times those long threes result in the long rebounds, and they had that zone pretty tightly packed in, so it's tough to get them. So the coach wants them to get them, but the guys, that's a tough break, that's all.
Pulling, got the screen, finds the open man, Southwell. Defensive foul against the Aggies. Grimm Oregon Grimm, the junior from Riverton, Utah, picks up his first for Utah State.
Well, Dan, let me ask you, what's the difference between this block charge and the one in the first half on Ty Wesley?
Well, I think the difference right there is that he did not have his position established before Southwell left his feet.
That's the 10th free throw attempt for Kansas State, 5 for Utah State.
And if you looked at the replay, he kept going towards Southwell, and so he actually moved into Southwell. So there's a couple of things there.
There goes Kelly. Jordan Enriquez Roberts comes back in the game. Southwell at the stripe. Under 2 seconds to play. Grimm. And that does our first half. As this is Utah State's lowest scoring first half this season with the 22 points. Their big gun, the WAC player of the year, Ty Wesley, is in foul trouble. And this is Utah State's largest halftime deficit of the season, 11 to Sam Ryan.
Coach, you're working the pressure, you're getting the turnovers. How do you keep up the defensive pressure second half?
I've been real happy with our defense for the most part. Magruder and Spradling guarding Poole. I don't know what they're thinking. We told them Scouter was going to shoot it. They're standing 4 feet away, hands down. We got a lead. We give up a cheap three there at the end of the half.
Jacob coming back from that fever. We know he's not 100%, but giving it all he can out there. What can you say about Jacob's performance tonight?
Yeah, he's a warrior. He answers the bell every time. I'm real proud of him.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Back to you.
That guy is a beauty. Frank Martin with Kansas State. Wildcats on top. We send you to the AT&T at the half after these messages. You're watching the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship.
Progress.
State by 11. They've got 10 more points at the free throw line than Utah State on an 81 degree night here in the desert southwest. Kevin Harlan, Reggie Miller, and Dan Bonner is here at 26. Consecutive tournament. You're doing a great job. Game four. We've been here.
We're somebody of my age, yes.
Yeah, you are an old man. What about Jacob Pullen? He has played under the weather tonight. He's got 10.
Well, he's played 18 minutes, and he has played a typical Jacob Pullen half. He has attacked the basket. He's played really well defensively. He's made free throws. He's made a three-point shot. So he's got 10 points. He's been pretty tough.
And the great agitator has been agitated by the length of Samuels and Kelly. Three fouls already in that first half for Ty Wesley. Look for him to settle down in this second half. I'm sure Coach Drew Morrell is going to still run that offense through him, but he has to be very careful. He doesn't pick up a quick foul in this second half.
So Wesley with those 11 minutes, 3 fouls, 2 points. We'll see if he can turn around this second half. Utah State, the 12th seed. Kansas State, the 5th seed. Here we go with the second half from Tucson.
And it's really important that Utah State gets off to a good start here in the second half.
And Kelly reaching in, picks up the foul for the Wildcats, trying to get the back pedal in Wesley. Kelly picks up his second personal foul.
You hear
foul.
These Utah State Aggie fans, someone mocking the officials here, like, finally you called one when Wesley is on the offensive end against Kelly.
Wendell is out there. Williams with the ball. Wesley down low. Newbold had it.
Well, Newbold hadn't scored tonight, and that hadn't helped the cause.
Wendell across the lane.
Well, I'll tell you what, Utah State could not have played any worse, and you're only down 11 points.
Against a very physical, athletic Kansas State team. Pullen got a screen. Samuels from way outside, launching the three. Rocky Thane tapped it, and here he comes the other way. He is the 5th Aggie on the floor. Southwell and Pullen, Magruder, Kelly, and Samuels for Kansas State to start the second half. Wesley again. Two right there as Kelly hit the deck.
I will say this, Ty Wesley, you are messing with fire with that move in particular. The way they called it, and they've called this game, that's an offensive foul, the way in their eyes. It's not, but the way they're calling it, it is.
Well, it wasn't that time, Reg.
Now here's this zone defense, the matchup. We've seen this a couple of times. Oh boy, Wesley reaching. You can't. Reached in there.
Got that foot. You can't do that.
Shot clock at 4. Pullen's got to make a move, and he does. Around Payne. Nice rebound by Magruder, but he can't get in the short one. And Bendel has it, and here comes Brock Keith Payne. In by Payne. Nice. Oh, he jets right to the rack. Utah State is back in business, and 2 minutes gone here in the second half.
And now they're back to their X defense, really that 3-2 matchup zone.
They trailed at one time, did the Aggies, by 14. Pullen, 3, no, Southwell. I think the last to touch it he was for the Wildcats.
Here we go now. Now the pressure is starting to rise up a little bit on both ends of the floor. Rocky Payne finally attacking that rim area, Dan. He's got the speed.
Right in transition, I think in particular, he's got to use that speed. Sometimes it's tough in the half court because you got to go into all those big arms, big guys with the long arms inside.
Bendel is off balance, regained his footing. Wesley in there playing with the three fouls. Oh, jumping on his back is just the motion of the play. The continuation of Samuels. He'll pick up the Kansas State foul so far. K-State has started the second half 0-4, and Utah State has started 2-3.
There's a different look in these Utah State Aggies' eyes, in particular Ty Wesley. Maybe they got a tongue lashing from their head coach at halftime, but I like how they've come out here.
The drive, the dive. Wesley puts it in. 6 points in a 6-0 start for Utah State. A motion in the building here in Tucson, and we've got ourselves a ball game. Wesley inside, follows it up well. The senior doesn't want his career to end. Untrue.
At AT&T.
Stu Morrill's Aggies have started on a 6-0 run here in the second half in Tucson.
And sometimes it starts with your best players. Ty Wesley with those three fouls in the first half. He has a different look about him. Gets the ball down low, just goes through the chest of Kansas State's player. And then Brocky Payne finally gets into the open floor to make something happen. And here, second shot opportunity. Ty Wesley, the look for the Utah State. Much different here in this second half.
Jordan, and here he goes. Roberts is in. There's a turnover on a play that was designed during the timeout, and Brock Keith Payne the other way with 3 minutes gone in this second half.
And the coaches are sitting over there saying, we got a timeout for this?
Newbold. Or the double team inside.
So he just has not been able to hit that short shot.
Kansas State, 0-for-7 over the last 6 minutes from the field, going back to the first half. Pullen dives, counted for 2 and a foul.
Part of the problem when you're trying to make a comeback against a team with a great player is that great player often interrupts your comeback. Here, Jacob Pullen just takes it hard to the basket, and that's a play where Bendel's just got to get out of the way. You either step in there to take the charge, you get out of the way. He went halfway, and the result is he picks up his third foul, and he's got to go to the bench.
Jardine comes in for Bendel. Bendel just picked up his third foul. Here's Pullen at the line. You take a look at the scores. Look at Michigan State making a run on UCLA. That's over on TBS. CBS with St. John's and Gonzaga. Missouri down by 10 to Cincinnati late in the second half. Jardine, Payne, and Ty Wesley back outside. Newbold.
Newbold still hadn't scored in the game. That's only his second shot attempt.
Jake Pullen tonight, 4-10.
There's no way Enriquez Roberts can guard Ty Wesley down low. Next time he gets the ball, Wesley has to be aggressive, make a quick move. Doesn't have the foot speed.
Spradling found the double. Kicks it outside to Jordan Henrique Roberts. Oh! Throws down a left-handed sledgehammer.
Even Jacob Fulham is looking over here at us laughing.
Payne into Poland. Outside. That's not going to fly in. Huber can't hit. Poland swerving inside. He does it again. Jacob Poland. Sensational move, and Kansas State back to 11.
Poland is sensational, particularly when he gets out in transition like that. Great body control to get that ball to the basket.
You can see he's got the 14 of a 6-0 run by Kansas State. Answering the 6-0 run to begin the second half by Utah State with a quick timeout taken by the Aggies. It's the angular one inside. Jordan Henrique Roberts.
You know, for Utah State, they just have to keep plugging away, Kevin. They've missed a couple of wide-open threes, and, you know, they go down, and it's a little bit different. So you just have to keep plugging away. Kansas State wasn't going to not score at all in the second half. You know, they're going to get some baskets. You just got to keep plugging away.
Payne, Spradling defends. That's an offensive foul on Bucky Payne. Number two.
You talk about the Utah State offense. I thought Poole Williams really waved off Ty Wesley down low. He should have gave him re-entered the ball down low.
The winner here will take on the Wisconsin Badgers on Saturday.
Ernie Johnson in New York updating the game on TNT. Cincinnati's Kashmir Wright, the jumper as soft as his name. 65-53 as we send you back to Tucson.
Yeah, thank you very much. As a look at Ty Wesley, his Utah State Aggies down 39-28. Samuels will inbound. Dave Roberts is still in the game, as is Spradling and Magruder and Pullen. Pullen, the only player in double figures with 14, 5 of 11 from the floor.
See if Utah State has another run in them.
There's still plenty of time.
Plenty of time.
Jardine is in. Spradling.
They've lost that aggressive nature at the offensive end.
Now Kansas State, after that Utah State, when Kansas State just, I think, doubled up on the defensive pressure.
Going across the lane, Magruder saves it. And a shot clock violation, a pretty valiant effort though by Rodney Magruder out of Washington, D.C.
That is maybe the classic facial expression of our day today. Frank Martin is thinking, no, we're not going to put that one in the playbook.
Look how far out the Utah State is starting their offense.
Look at Wesley, corkscrew inside for two.
Reggie, that's exactly what you were talking about. Enriquez Roberts simply is not capable of guarding Wesley, particularly that far from the basket.
Enriquez Roberts picks up his second personal foul for the Wildcats.
Now, the dangerous thing for Wesley making a dribble move from that far away from the basket is that somebody might step in and take a foul. But Enriquez Roberts, he actually slugged his own teammate, Spradling, shoved him out of the way. So Spradling was trying to get there to take a charge, but never managed.
Wesley might be the greatest player in the history of Utah State basketball. That's kicked. Green got in the way. Green. Out on the floor. James Walker is out there as well. They got Brady Jardine, Wesley, and Poole Williams, the five for the Aggies.
Now Green is another guy. We've talked about him before. He's a very, very dangerous three-point shooter, but he hadn't been able to get his shot because the Kansas State guys are just covering him up.
Samuels a screen for Pullen. Samuels down low. That's an offensive foul. He's got four. And that is a story for the Wildcats. Curtis Kelly will come back in.
Well, now you've cut the lead down to 8 with the basketball.
You know, Reggie, when you're trying to make a comeback, it's very rare that you score like 13 points in a row and come back. You make a little bit of a comeback,
chip away, and the other team answers.
You just got to keep playing.
And see, this defensive pressure by Kansas State is really making things difficult.
Well, when a team pressures you like this, you got to have press releasers, and you got to have some backdoor cuts, and you've got to have some second and third options, which I really haven't seen here from the Aggies.
Yeah, but lots of times, if there's so much pressure on the ball, they really can't, the guys who have the ball can't see it.
Pick and pop with Russell, he'll take it inside. Walker to the rack, knocked it. Here goes Robertson out of bounds. It goes. The shot clock is at 8 seconds.
Enriquez Robertson is doing an excellent job defensively. Just so long and blocking shots, deflecting balls. Nice job off the bench for Frank Martin.
Green. Walker. Pulling with a nice deflection. Shot clock at 5.
Yeah, but see, they're trying to run Green off that screen down low. And Jacob Pullen, he's such a good player and such a smart player. He knows that he's not going to give him any room to breathe.
Top your screen there is your Michigan State UCLA. That's getting close, 4 points. Wesley, who is 3 of 3, and he is fouled as he goes ping-ponging his way inside. And a foul, and Enriquez Roberts picks up 3.
And if all else fails, put your head down, Ty, and jump into the body of Enriquez Roberts.
And we're speaking of bodies. Wesley's got a pretty thick one and a big one, and
yes,
so
he does.
Spradling a little leery about getting in front to try to draw the charge.
Wesley.
Oh boy,
another missed free throw for Wesley. 1 of 4 from the free throw line. What, 72%? 72% on the season.
Well, as a team tonight, 2 of 7. Kansas State, 11 of 12. Utah State, 10 points this half. 8 have been by Wesley. The rest of the team, 1 of 9.
Utah State faithful. These fans are waiting for something to happen again for this team.
And Utah State's climbed back in the game. Now they just got to hang around. And as you said, Reggie, gradually chip away.
Pulling. Kelly set a screen. Spradling hoisting a 3. He's got his first basket tonight. Freshman from Overland Park, Kansas.
And he's a guy, Kevin, he just picks his spots. Doesn't force anything. That was a pretty good spot.
Wesley again, grinding on the block, doubled inside. Jardine, another foul on Kansas State. Their attack at the rim is Utah State. Enriquez Roberts has 4, Samuels has 4. Those are 2 big guys for the Cats.
This is a controlled rebound tip by Jardine right here. See the miss by Wesley. Jardine gets in there and looks like the foul on the wrist there by Roberts.
That was good patience by Wesley. He got inside and he faked, and what he did is draw 3 defenders to him, so nobody was available to block out Jardine.
K-State very small now. There goes Enriquez Roberts. Southwell will check in. And Jardine at the line, starting the first 7 games of the season. Now he's coming off the bench. He has had more of an effect on this Aggie team since that is happened.
Now can they come up with stops here at the defensive end? And I imagine, well, no, they're in man-to-man now. I like when they play more man. Communication is better, and they have more hands-on the offensive player.
Williams was watching the ultra-quick pulling.
You know, if I'm Stu Morrell, I might steal a minute or two to take Ty Wesley out, just so he doesn't pick up that 4th foul. If you can get a couple minutes and then let him play the rest of this game with 3 fouls, you just don't want him picking up a ticky-tack foul against a crafty player like Curtis Kelly.
But see, now with the smaller lineup, he's got to guard Kelly.
Ruder for 3. Southwell with a good-looking rebound inside, and he can't hit it from front-point range. Pulling.
When you're trying to make a comeback, you can't keep giving a team 2 and 3 looks.
Stepped out of bounds. Southwell stepped out of bounds. And the defense applied on the play by Brady Jardine. 8-point game. K-State on top. 11:48 in the second half.
April 17th on TNT.
Welcome back to Tucson. Kansas State head coach Frank Martin, animated to say the least. Now, he gets so fired up during these games, the players try not to make eye contact with him, his own players, when they go to the bench, because he will stay on them, yap away, and give them that look. The fans know it as the death stare.
He is a good coach, though. I'm telling you what.
And he's a great guy.
He is. I mean,
he really is.
Animated, so intense. His team reflects that. 1.5 to play. Wesley on top. Green. And Walker. Williams out there, and Jordy, and that's the 5 for the Indians.
And we got to get the ball to Ty Wesley on the switch.
Shot clock at 7. Switch on defense. Williams the 3. Hits nothing but air.
Reggie, that's a great call. They got, with all the switching that Kansas State was doing, Will Spradling was matched up against Ty Wesley, and they never found him.
Look at the game on TBS. UCLA, Michigan State. The Spartans making an incredible run, down by 4. Just seconds left there. Here's Pullen. And 11 to play. 9 minutes gone. State has not shot the ball well. 36% for the game. Kelly a screen. Wide open. Spradling launching a 3. He's done it again. His second triple hoisted and hit tonight in the second half.
The one player you really don't want to leave open, and that's Spradling right there. You've got to do a better job if you're going to be in that zone of communicating.
Walker, good ball rotation. To Williams. Going out and Pullen is there. Jake Pullen. Magruder. Kelly had it. Little shove, and that is a foul on Utah State inside the paint. It's going to go on Walker. He picks up his second for the Yankees.
Boy, Kansas State is just relentless attacking the backboards. I mean, they've got 12 offensive rebounds in the game now. They just keep going after it.
I really like the activity of Curtis Kelly.
And that's why the coach is so intense. Keeps him really fine-tuned. Kelly will take it in. Reggie just said he's a 6'8 senior out of the Bronx, New York. Last 4 games, he's averaged 15 points and 8 rebounds. 6 points tonight for Curtis Kelly.
Well, I think his offense is so important to this Kansas State squad, and that just goes right through Newbold's hands.
He just checked in, too.
And it's been a really rough night for Newbold. He's only had 3 shot attempts. He's missed them all. Hasn't scored.
Bendel is in. Here's Brock Heath Payne watching the freshman Spradling. Kelly. Kelly playing with 4 personal fouls. Magruder. A little shove. Looks like they got Bendel again. He's got 4.
You know, the way that Kansas State runs their offense and the way they've been applying that sticky defense of them, if you're Utah State, you just feel like this game is slowly but surely kind of slipping away from you. Every time you seem to make a run, you look back up at the scoreboard, and you're down 12, 13 points.
Morgan Grimm has just checked in. As Nate Bendel had to leave. Very physical inside.
Grimm had some words for Kelly as well. Looks like Southwell has some words right back for Grimm. There's the words right there down to Kelly.
Little travel. K-State turnover. Green.
Defend the 3-point line against Belmont very, very well, and that's what we're seeing here from Kansas State. They're really getting out and defending the 3-point line. Utah State, just nothing doing from beyond the arc.
Jardine couldn't hit. Here comes Pullen. 2 players in double figures. Wesley's got 10. Pullen's got 14. Missed by Spradling from beyond the arc and out of bounds with 8:46 to play here in the second half. As the officials confer, it will be Utah State's ball. Martin is beside himself.
Well, he's saying that Brian Green is the one that threw it off the backboard.
Final 4 seconds, UCLA, Michigan State on TBS. We've had so many close games.
Greg Gumbel in New York. Over on TBS, what was once a 23-point lead for UCLA is down to one. They're trying to inbound the ball. Let's listen in.
He's an adventure trying to get it in.
Honeycutt. Was there a grab of the jersey? Looks like Keebler gets called for the personal. So UCLA didn't even have to enter the basketball.
Well, that's right here. You got a little hand on Lee from behind, and there's a grab with the left hand shaping up.
So Lee is heading to the free throw line. UCLA up by one. Mike Nance heading over to the scorer's table, and both teams will huddle up here. 4.4 remaining. Michigan State wanted to sub in, but no time came off the clock. You can't make a substitution.
Right.
Two shots. Malcolm Lee, first team all Pac-10 squad this year, 79%. The junior from Moreno Valley, California. First one, knocks it down. 78-76, UCLA.
See if Jones tries to keep Lucas from getting this basketball right now. Lee makes this shot.
No timeouts remaining. Lee missed it. Long. Knocked up in the air. Michigan State's going to have a chance.
That's a walk.
He traveled with 0.2 on the clock. UCLA is going to pull out a close one.
Let's see if he gets the motors going before he puts the ball down. Well, it's close.
We need 1 second on the clock. Let's send you back to your game.
While you were away, Kelly had an alley-oop dunk for Kansas State. The lead propelled to 49-36. 13-point advantage, the biggest lead for the Wildcats tonight. There's been 14 in a game that had two early ties and two lead changes. 7:54 in the second half. The winner will take on the Wisconsin Badgers on Saturday here in Tucson. More points at the free throw line than Utah State. You see the three-point shooting. You see the field goal percentage about the same. And the 13-point Wildcat lead here. Under 8 to play in the second half.
Well, really has been a struggle for both teams offensively from 2 or 3. But really, I think it's been the defensive pressure by Kansas State that's been the difference in this game. Seems like every time Utah State making a run, K-State has the answer.
Well, Dan, we just saw Wesley for Utah State, 4 of 5 this half. The other Aggies, a combined 1 of 10 in this half.
Well, they're doing a great job getting out on the shooters. Williams, Green, they don't have any room at all.
Green with a three, defended by Magruder, who chases down the board, and he's got 5 rebounds, and pulling with a game-high 14 the other way for the Wildcats.
And Reggie, you could just see how big a hurry Green was in to get that shot off. He could feel Magruder coming.
If you wear Magruder's jersey too, you'd be running and be in a hurry.
I wouldn't want to go over and face Frank Martin if I didn't.
Rim fouls Kelly, who has the 8 points and 5 rebounds tonight. 7:22 here in the second. Grimm, who comes in, has 2 fouls so far for the Yankees. Pullen under the weather. Fever yesterday. I don't know how much it's dissipated as he takes it inside. Across the lane, Wesley with the rebound. Rakeith Payne Big shot right here for the Yankees, and they get it. That's Drew Williams lacing up a three. His third three tonight.
Reggie, their best offense has been in transition.
Absolutely. Well, really, that's because Kansas State can't put hands on them. In that half-court situation, they're all over them defensively. When you're in transition, kind of get lost in translation a little bit.
Horn, Magruder, Spradlin. Shot clock at 9. Magruder, Kelly with the screen. Switch on D. Three-point shot there. He's got 8. His second triple tonight.
Reggie, that's just what you're talking about. Utah State scores the three, and Kansas State answers with one of their own.
They've answered all night long.
Yeah, they sure have.
Well, they've gotten the switch here, but they can't take advantage. Bradley does a good job of forcing Ty Wesley out to the three-point line.
Rocky Thames, shot clock down to 7. 6 to play in the game. By the way, shot clock at 4.
Rocky Payne.
3.
Has been a window pane tonight. He's been invisible for the Utah State Aggies. Outplayed by Jacob Fulham.
Well, the former University of Houston player, Midland Junior College. 11 points is what he averages.
And he's only got 1 field goal.
Green inside. Wesley attacks the glass and tips it back in. Where would they be without him tonight?
Well, and then you can tell how much they missed him when he had to go to the bench with those fouls in the first half.
14 points for Wesley. Tie is from Provo, Utah. Kelly again. Grim defense. Wesley doubles. Spradling hoisting a 3. Ooh, down goes Kelly. And he is in pain.
And that may be an elbow foul. Because it looks like he got hit in the neck, and so I think they're going to go over and they're going to look at it on the monitor.
Well, remember, Kelly and Grimm got into it a couple minutes ago. There was some jawing going on with Southwell. Kind of entered the fray. It happened so quick, it might have been an elbow.
Now, tough to see here.
Is this the intentional, or they're going to go and...
Well, right here, right here.
Yep, got him right across the Adam's apple with his left forearm.
And they're going to call that an intentional foul.
Yep.
The rule basically is if you make contact with the elbow above the shoulders, then it has to be a minimum of an intentional foul. It can be a flagrant foul, and the flagrant foul means that you would be thrown out of the game. But the penalty is the same here. It'll be 2 shots for Kelly. He was the person who was fouled, and Kansas State will get the ball.
Now, if it's a flagrant foul and you're thrown out of the game, don't you miss the next game as well?
That's on a fight.
Okay.
Kelly, a 52% free throw shooter. Tonight, 2 of 2 and 3 of 3.
Well, now, not that it would have mattered, but Utah State was hanging around. They were only down 11. Now you get 2 free throws and the ball and possession. I think that's what Stu Morrell was telling his young player. You can't put us in that type of situation when we're trying to make runs and we're digging ourselves out of holes.
Kelly with 10. He averages 10.
Well, that is that rule is very strictly enforced. They're trying to protect, obviously, kids from being hit in the head with elbows.
Kelly. Bendel with the rebound. Grimm is out. Bendel back in with 4 fouls. Look at the drive right here by Brocky Payne.
And that's what Payne should have been doing all game. Just putting his head down and going to the basket. Even if it wasn't successful, it would have made the Kansas State defense suffocate to him, and maybe they could have gotten a few wide-open looks for Green or Newbold or someone like that.
UCLA, by the way, won that game against Michigan State, holding off the Spartans with Payne at the line. Check out the Powerade Ion 4-point performance ranking system to get a peek into the science behind tournament success. See where your team ranks at NCAA.com/Powerade. Pullen is 5 of 12. Magruder, Southwell, Kelly with the screen. Spradling to Wildcat, five on the floor. Approaching five to play in the second half. Kelly, Southwell with a screen. Kelly right there. He's got 12.
What a great job by Jacob Pullum to find him at exactly the right time. That's what a point guard's supposed to do, deliver the ball to the right guy at the right time, and Pullum has done it all night long.
He's got four assists. That's a good-looking three-point shot. Drew Williams out of Federal Way, Washington. He's got 14.
Now, Kevin, it's a 10-point game.
Again.
You know, they're not out of it.
Now, I won't say there's plenty of time, but if they can continue to keep getting good three-point looks, just like Williams got in steals like this.
Now they got the breakaway. Oh, across the face. Rakeith Kane goes down hard.
Now this is huge, because now you get two free throws in possession.
Magruder picks up his first personal foul for the Wildcats.
And this is not very smart right here if you're Magruder.
No, you just let him go. You just let him go.
That's above, yes.
Now, you can claim that he was making a play on the ball, but this is an intentional foul because of excessive contact, and that's really one of the reasons that the intentional foul rule was put in, so you can protect players in that particular situation.
Well, how important are these free throws? If you can knock both of these down, you cut the lead to eight, you get possession, chance to cut it to either five or six.
John Cal is our lead official tonight with the nine Final Fours, five national championship games. He's the gray-haired gentleman right there talking to Stu Morrill. Stu Morrill, by the way, one of the great, great people in college basketball. We had a wonderful visit with him last night.
Now, there was blood on Rakeith Payne. Now, he does get a chance to shoot these free throws because it looked like...
Well, now, if you can't shoot your free throws... Because you go down and it's... See, Payne is bleeding, so he can't shoot the free throw.
Intentional foul followed by the shooter with blood so that he's going to be subbed out and replaced.
All right. And what this is Stu Morrill, he gets to pick somebody else to shoot the free throw.
That was on the floor, which is Brian Green.
He's a 73% free throw shooter, and he gets that one to trickle in and make it a 9-point ball game with 4:22 to play.
Now, if he had, it was an intentional foul, first of all, so even if he had been injured, Stu Morrill still could have picked the free throw shooter. But if there was no blood and no intentional foul, then Frank Martin would have been able to pick the free throw shooter.
Martavius Irving will check in. Pullen is out. Southwell is out.
There's a lot of deaths there going on over there at that Kansas State bench with Frank Martin talking to Jacob Pullen.
Jamar Samuels checks in as well. Nice move by Williams! Dropping the sledgehammer! 6-point game! What a play!
Again, knocking on the door. You're only down 6 points. A little over 4 minutes left.
Reggie, now you do have plenty of time.
Yes,
you
do.
You've got to get some stops.
No silly fouls as well. Good defense here. Keep everyone in front of you and contest all shots.
Shot clock at 7. Magruder, Samuels the screen. Confusion on the side. The Aggies get the ball. The tournament at its best. Kansas State is led by double digits, a large portion of the game. Williams comes in and throws down a beautiful left-hander.
If you could have your perfect cell phone, what would that do for you? Please.
Some terrific finishes today. Butler by two over Old Dominion. Morehead State, the 13th seed over the 4 seed Louisville. We had 12 Richmond over 5 Vanderbilt by 3. Well, we have another fantastic finish here in Tucson tonight as Utah State is on a 7-0 run.
I walked.
He sure did. That was Rakeith Payne with the unforced error, the turnover. This is the closest the game has been in the last 13 minutes.
And Stu Morrill's not really very happy about that. But again, how many times have we seen the Kansas State pressure disrupt what Utah State's trying to do?
Kelly, Magruder picked up by Green.
down six. Now let's see if K-State makes him pay.
Kelly can't hit. Samuels chases it down, and Spradlin controls, approaching three to play.
Turnover at one end. You're giving up second shot opportunities at the other. Not a recipe that you want.
Jake Pullen. Samuels. Got it to go. Crushing his way inside. He's got four.
Now K-State trying to turn up the pressure. Oh, my.
It is out of bounds and 27 seconds on the shot clock. 8-point game.
This K-State pressure defense really has this Utah State Aggie team frazzled down the stretcher. That's where you got to go. But you got to make a quick move.
Whistling. No! Foul. Kelly was defending. Number three.
Well, now, Reggie, you have to make the free throws, and that's something that Utah State has not done with great consistency tonight. They're 9 for 14.
How about the way Wesley has survived the second half and been a huge part of the offense?
Yeah, he's really done a nice job.
Yeah.
Hadn't picked up a foul, but he's only 2 for 6 from the line. That's a big free throw there.
It is.
So, again, you put points on the scoreboard. With the clock stopped, you get a chance to set your defense. You got 2:34 left in this game.
Yeah, but how big was that traveling violation?
Now they're down 6, and Kansas State has the ball. Before, they were down 6, and they had the ball, and they turned it over, and K-State came down and scored. Well, now, if you're Kansas State, you've got to run some time off the clock here.
Pulling with the slashing move. Jacob Pullen. 16 points at K-State High. And a heroic play right there. Rockeith Payne right through traffic, right to the hole. Back and forth we go in Tucson.
And he could have been doing that all night with that speed by Rockeith Payne.
Well, now, though, if you're Utah State, we're going back and forth, but they can't go back and forth. They can't trade baskets with them. They've got to get stops and scores.
Well, they also, Kansas State has one of the ultimate closers, as we just saw in Jacob Pullen.
When you have a great player, it helps, doesn't it? Curtis Kelly. He hits that over Nate Bendel. 14 for Kelly. 4 above his season average. Green.
But look at Jacob Pullen get out on him. He's not going to give him anywhere anything like a look at a three.
Williams for three. Kelly with the rebound. He's snared 6. Approaching a minute to play. Green has to reach in, has to stop the ball, has to stop the clock.
Well, I agree with you, but they should have done that as soon as they got the rebound. You didn't have time to run 11 seconds off the clock there. There's not enough time left in the game to wait that long before you foul.
Kansas State from the free throw line has been magnificent tonight. 13 of 14. Pullen. We've got inside March Madness presented by Buick. Next coming up on True TV, a busy day in this round 2. Pullen from the free throw line, 4 of 5.
Well, I tell you what, gentlemen, Kansas State goes on to win this game. Think about some of the defensive pressure on Saturday between Kansas State and Wisconsin.
Oh.
The bigs of Ruhr and Nakenville and Brusewitz going against Samuels and Curtis Kelly, Enriquez Roberts.
How about a matchup between Jordan Taylor and,
yes,
and Pullen, Jacob Pullen? Spradlin is out, Southwell is in. Rockeith Payne, Wesley and Green, Bendel, Payne for three. That's a perfect shot from outside. Timeout Aggies. 7-point game, 60 seconds to play. Utah State has one timeout. The Wildcats have 3. We'll come back to Tucson after this.
You don't have an iPhone.
Frank Martin's Wildcats down the stretch here have made 4 of their last 5 shots from the floor.
Well, you got to take care of the basketball here, and you understand this is going to be a free throw game for this last minute, but you got to secure the basketball as Kansas State is taking in as if you're Curtis Kelly.
Well, and Kansas State won't mind the free throw game, Reggie. They're 15 out of 16 from the line tonight.
Kelly to Bullock. And a quick foul. That's going on Pooh Williams. Assessed his third. 2 seconds off the clock.
And this is the guy you want at the free throw line. If you're Kansas State, you throw the ball into Jacob Pullen, and Reggie used the perfect term, a closer. And he's going to close it out for you.
He's the second all-time leading scorer at K-State. Right in back of Mike Evans. One of his big games this season, the 38 points in the win over number one KU earlier in the year. Highly decorated Jacob Pullen. He's got 19 and he's got 20. Pullen averages 19 a game. Green. Wesley to the rack. 7 point game. Pullen trying to get out of traffic. Knocked away by Wesley. And that is his fourth personal foul.
How huge would that have been?
That was very close.
How huge would that have been? Got a little bit of wrist right there, but
well, that's at this portion of the game, you're always calls always going to be made. You're reaching from behind, trying to swat the ball away. That's what guys do all the time when they're trying to foul. Right. So the referee's not going to give you that one.
And you can see the free throw shooting for the season and what they have done tonight. That has been a big part of Kansas State's lead, keeping it that way. Wildcat band and Pullen.
Oh, misses both.
Wesley dives. Rockheath Payne has it.
Now you need a big three.
He looks and fires. And a big rebound inside by Magruder.
Utah State, Reggie, is going to look back and see spots in this game where they had opportunities and either they turned the ball over or they just weren't able to make the big shot. But this certainly wasn't a game where they were blown out or dominated. They just missed some opportunities.
I tell you what, if they would have started the game the way they started the second half in this last 7 or 8 minutes, especially Brockheath Payne, I thought he was going to be key because of his speed to match up with Jacob Pullen. If he could attack the rim all game like that, I think their offense probably would have settled in a little bit better than it did.
Good point. Stu Morrill starts four seniors. Tough game tonight against Kansas State. Well, if you're a senior and you lose, this is the last game maybe you're playing. A lot of these guys are men who have gone on missions for the Mormon faith. Four are married. Six guys have been away and are in their mid-20s. We talked about the four senior starters. 37 seconds to play. This may be the final game.
And that's a heck of a record right there. Yep. And this is a team that won 30 games this year. And again, you get to this tournament, there's so much emphasis put upon playing in the NCAA tournament. And so if you lose in the first round, you tend to sometimes think that this season where you won 30 game isn't successful, Reggie. But this was a great, great season for Utah State.
Well, if I'm head coach Stu Morrill, I'm excited. And I'm glad for my seniors because they won a lot of basketball games for me. And they left a lot on the floor this entire season.
Samuel just picked up his fifth. So he'll foul out of the game. Southwell will take his place. And Frank Martin got just enough out of this guy. He was fighting some foul problems tonight. He got the 4 points. Wildcats on top. Payne at the line. Aggies coming in and won 3 consecutive WAC regular season titles. Outright, they shared a fourth. They have not advanced beyond the first round since 2001, but boy, have they put together some teams, winning at least 23 games in 12 consecutive seasons.
Well, Kevin, if you would trace down the list of the teams that they've played in those losses in the first round, it's like murderer's row.
Very tough, you're right. Big time BCS conference rules.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, really good teams, and they faced a really good team tonight. in Kansas State that played very, very well.
Shane Southwell calls a timeout. 32 seconds to play. Kansas State up by 7. Looking for the Badgers. Seconds to play. Aggies aren't going quietly here, are
no,
they?
And you know, you get a steal, you hit a three, you never know.
Absolutely. Southwell to inbound. Kelly. And Wesley comes up on him.
I've seen funnier things, gentlemen. And I like how Utah State here is not giving up here.
Wesley is gone. The WAC Player of the Year. We began our broadcast talking about Ty, a senior from Provo. I thought it was interesting. Stu Morrill said he's one of the top five players that I have been around, and I've coached for a lot of years in terms of basketball IQ. He thinks the game so well, and he is the heart and soul of this Aggie team.
Well, he's going to give you everything that he has at both ends of the floor. And we were talking about Frank Martin having that death stare. I think Ty Wesley, as a player, is one of those players that is so intense and it's kind of infectious if you are playing with him. He's one of those guys that you hate to play against, but you want him on your team.
Payne is going to take it inside. Foul on Kingston. 22 seconds to play. Free throws coming up for the Aggies. Kelly picks up his fourth personal foul. Well, you know, as a coach, you can never exhale until it's all zeros on
you can't.
On the clock.
And you get disgusted with your guys because in this situation, it's going to be hard for them to beat you two at a time. And so you don't want them to score while the clock isn't running. As long as you can get the ball inbounds and make a free throw, then you're going to win the game. So you don't want to foul them. If they're going to drive to the basket and shoot two, let them go.
Payne again with two right there. 6-point game, 22 seconds to play. Penn has 9 of Utah State's last 11. Southwell, the freshman, to another freshman, Spradling, and a quick whistle. Not quick enough for Utah State. Couple seconds off the clock. Foul will go on Brock Heath Payne. That is the third on Payne. Payne, I mentioned before, he played at the University of Houston. Then he went to Midland Junior College, where they were the number one ranked team in junior college basketball. And then he comes to Utah State. Southwell at the line. Well, Utah State has cut it to 6 4 times in the closing moments. Wesley fouling out moments ago. Again, he got it, and Pullen will pick up the foul.
Dan, what did you just say? When they're driving to the basket, let them go.
First on Pullen.
Two does not hurt you right here. A 3-point play.
Payne from the line, 7 of 8.
Is this like the game that would never end?
This is the NCAAs, man. This is what it's all about. These teams that will not die. Mature teams like the Yankees. A lot of character. Pullen quickly fouled. Jardine bounced into him. I mean, we're moving chess pieces here. We're just moving in incremental steps. But this is how you coach these final seconds when your team is down. And you just hope you can whittle away enough to have a shot.
You're absolutely right. And, you know, for Kansas State, Pullen, you know, he needs to make free throws. But
remember, he missed the last two. He's 7 of 10 tonight. And he drains that one. Green is back in. There goes Lugold.
Well, now you've got to get the ball up the court if you're Utah State very quickly, and you have to get a three. You don't have time to drive it for two anymore, unless, of course, Kansas State is going to follow you again, and then you can get a three-point play the old-fashioned way.
No player in the history of Kansas State has played more games than Jacob Pullen. Payne. Green, two. It's a long two, and a timeout taken by the Aggies. 5.9, 73-68. Timeout, Utah State. He was close to a three. Hits a long two.
It's processor and Beats Audio. Hear music the way the artist intended. Only on HP. Everybody on.
Ryan Green, a senior, just hit that long two. He's known for threes, and he had a foot inside the arc.
Well, Kansas State, again, getting chased off that three-point line.
Yeah, Rodney Magruder was right out on him. He could not have attempted a three because Magruder wouldn't let him.
You want to create a scenario here with 5.9 to play, and you're down 73-68. Magruder right there, knocked away. Newbold with the rejection, Green with the three, and that'll do it. And the Kansas State Wildcats survive a late push by the Aggies. They'll take on the Wisconsin Badgers on Saturday. 73-68. Third consecutive year, the Wildcats will go to the round of 32. Jacob Pullen tonight had 22 for K-State. Curtis Kelly, 15 points and 6 boards. Utah State had 3 in double figures. Wesley at 18 to lead them all. Dorothy looks a little dejected.
Well, the Wizard of Oz just went off in his balloon and left her.
Let's go to Sam Ryan.
Well, Coach, you played your defensive style for the most part for most of the game, but they certainly made it interesting down the stretch, especially after that 7-0 run. You're shaking your head. Rather than trying to read your expressions, how do you describe this one?
It's a joke. We're lucky to win here today. We were undisciplined, unfocused the whole second half. You know, we're just lucky to win. And at this time of year, you can't dwell on things. If you win, you get to play again. So, you know, we're just lucky right now.
And you do get to play again. Let's bring in Jacob Pullen now. Jacob Pullen had 22 points on the night. I know under tough circumstances for you, you had the fever less than 24 hours ago. How tough was it for you tonight?
It was tough, but it's about winning. I'm a competitor, and, you know, I never let my team down by letting an illness or anything just take me out of the way of playing in this game.
And it's on to Wisconsin now on Saturday. Guys, back to you.
Sam, thank you very much. Pulling one of the most decorated players in the history of Kansas State basketball. They'll take on the Badgers in a beauty coming up on Saturday. Coming up on True TV, Inside March Madness presented by Buick, with all the highlights and analysis of a 16-game day. For Dan Bonner, Reggie Miller, Sam Ryan, Kevin Arlen saying goodnight from the desert of Tucson.